you're trying to survive, you have access to fresh water and calories just by gnawing on it. It's brilliant. And then when you land in a new place, you can throw it in the ground and propagate from there. You get to grow 34 unique varietals of those heirloom Hawaiian sugar canes on our 350 acres. Every single one of those canes tastes different, has its own story, its own history, and we're lucky to be able to share all of those. Now within those, just like Cabernet Sauvignon doesn't taste like Pinot Grigio, none of you would look at me in the face and say a grape is a grape is a grape. But sugar cane's been treated that way forever. But it's not that way. We're the first distillery in the world to use single varietal sugar canes to make our rums. This is made with a sugar cane called Coke. That's the white sugar cane, one of 34 types. Unique, delicious, and really fun. Kokea was King Kamehameha the Great's favorite cane, and a cane that was planted almost on every single island across the chain. So a really famous and amazing cane that we get to grow. Now, estate grown, that's the first part of our trident. Heirloom Hawaiian sugar cane, and the thing that probably makes the most difference in terms of flavor is going to be we use fresh sugarcane juice as opposed to molasses. 97% of the world's rums are made with molasses, the byproduct of the industrial sugar complex, that waste product. It's a brilliant way of making rum. It's very cheap, and you've got all the sugars you need, so it's turning trash into treasure. We skip that whole process and only use the fresh sugarcane juice. So our rums are going to be more vibrant. They're going to be brighter. They're going to speak to something more vegetal and real. They're going to have some health to them. So for us, we're really proud to grow heirloom Hawaiian sugarcane on single farms in Hawaii, not outsource anything, and then be able to just use that fresh pressed juice instead of some other molasses based or sugar based thing. And that's how you're going to come across Kohana. That's who we are, it's what we are, and with that, you're able to elevate any rum cocktail, from a mojito to a El Presidente or a daiquiri, all the way to Hawaii's most famous cocktail, which is the Mai Tai. Now let's transition into that, shall we? Does anybody know where the Mai Tai was invented? I got a hand. It is very famous from the Royal Hawaiian Bar, but it was not invented there. Anybody know? Oakland, Alameda. Trader Vic in Alameda, California invented the Mai Tai. The story of the Mai Tai goes like this. Trader Vic is in an arms war with Don Beach, Don the Beachcomber, trying to make all of these Polynesian restaurants and these exotica things happen throughout California. They wanted to share what they viewed as their seafaring adventures, from whether it was one guy was really rich, the other guy was in the Navy. They wanted to share what they thought of Polynesia and Asia and all of these places. So you went into Trader Vic's restaurant, and there were about 7 Filipino guys in the back actually doing all the work, making all the drinks. Fun little tidbit about Trader Vic. All of the drinks were made in the back, but he was putting the show on in the front. And unless it was somebody really special, he actually didn't make any of the drinks. They were popping out from 7 dudes hanging out in the back, making the best drinks in California for no credit. Really, really wild. But one day he has a buddy come in, and he brings in his fiance, who happens to be a Polynesian woman. She's Tahitian. So she's like, "Vic, can you make me something?" And he's like, "Of course I can." And so he goes, "I know everything in here generally is made from rum, so I'm gonna use rum as my base." And he grabs a 17-year Jamaican rum. He's like, "I know how to balance a cocktail. I just need sour and sweet, so I'm just gonna play with those proportions. I'm gonna take some lime juice, take about 1 ounce of lime juice, put it in there. Now I've gotta balance that out. I'm gonna balance it with some sugar. Well, that sugar that I'm gonna use, I'm not just gonna use sugar, I'm gonna use orange curacao, which is an orange liqueur from the island of Curacao, and I'm gonna use a French almond syrup known as orgeat. So now you've got this nutty syrup, you've got this fun, bright orange liqueur, you've got the brilliance of what lime juice brings to the cocktail, and then a really amazing rum. mixes it all up, and he passes it across the bar to the Tahitian lady, and she exclaims, "Mai Tai Roi," which in Tahitian apparently means, "This is out of the world, the best." And the Mai Tai was born from a Polynesian woman naming a Howley Dude's drink in Oakland, California, and ended up getting changed a million times over throughout all of those years. Now, if you come to Hawaii nowadays, you'll get some people that'll be making this type of Mai Tai. If you want to find it, look for